Hello everybody, welcome to my channel, to part 5 of my Williams FW11, where I finally have something to show you. But before that, as I said in my last video, I had something new, some kits that I bought, and I said at the time that I was going to buy a little more things to those kits, and one of those things is this photo edge kit for the 360 Modena for Tamiya, and here it is from Hobby Design. Already took a look around, and very good, wasn't cheap, almost 30 euros, so I don't know, maybe I'll see what it's worth when I'm building the Ferrari. Also, I found this two kits from Tamiya. These are kits that are no longer in production, following the Williams from PK. Also bought this older Brabham. I found them on a site called King Kits. It isn't the cheapest one, but they have some models you might not find in the other places, so especially this. I tried everywhere to find an Aston Martin DBS, but I couldn't, and I found this one there at King Kits. And it was quite expensive, to be honest. All the places I've seen it when it was for sale, it was around 40 euros, 45 euros, and this one was 50, not euros, but pounds. So it wasn't cheap, but finally I have the DBS. It was a kit I was looking forward to for a very long time, and finally I have one. Also, but from Hero Boy, I bought photo edge kit, of course, very complete set, also from Hobby Design, and also bought this. What are these? These are decals for the Aston Martin, but they are metal ones to simulate all the chrome parts that Aston Martins usually have. Okay, enough of this. Let's go to the main theme, which is the Williams. And so far, lots of work later, it's starting to look like an F1 car. This has been a real pain, to be honest, because of the photo edge parts. I'll try to make this as quick as possible, so the video doesn't get too long. First thing, these radiators. This side is already covered, but the other one isn't, because the radiator has some photo edge attached to it, and it has an inner duct here. And what happens? The side pod doesn't have enough room to fit, so if I try to fit here, it will get up here, and if I try to fit here, it won't fit here. That's for starters. The engine, almost complete. I'm starting to dress it up with some tubing, like this one here. I'll make some other tubing I have from reference photos, but it's finished, pretty much finished. So moving to the cockpit part, I've showed it in previous videos how it is attached where it belongs to. I don't see if it's perceptible or not. Not too much light in here. But I've only have left the rear wing. It's here, ready for clear coating. Let me zoom up a little bit. The side plates, which are for wedge, and the upper part of the wing, which is a good part. Sanded the tires. There's something a lot of people nowadays usually notice when you take care of the tires or not. And as you can see, a bit of a seam there, but I don't want to sand down too much. Okay, now, for if somebody noticed, the front wing isn't complete yet, and I know this is a bit of an odd thing, but for two main reasons. First, the side plates are for wedge, which are painted and the decals applied, but still need to clear coat it. So I'll be attaching that one later. And then, because of a problem in my second part of this build, if I'm not mistaken, I talked about the clear coating that I've made with Umbro enamels, which didn't go very good, and I had to strip it down. I also talked about a site that I found that produces decals for a lot of single-seaters already. He's planning to have more variety to his stock, but I found the decals for this car and I ordered them. This site is called indicals.net and it's from the US, which is not a major problem, at least for me. I don't know in any other European countries, but for me it's pretty good. But speaking of the problem, the Goodyear logos that comes to the upper part of the front wing are supposed to be white, and in this case they are black. So I contacted the owner, and to address this problem, because I searched in my stash of decals to see if I had any white Goodyear logos, but with no success. So I contacted the owner. His name is Michael Portaro, if I'm not mistaken, and he's a hell of a guy. He already knew about this problem, and he offered me to send me some new decals with the correct Goodyear logo. Well, I accepted it, of course, especially because I don't have any white Goodyear logos. And I'm really pleased with the service he provided, and I recommend, definitely, I recommend. It's only a shame, because he only manufactures decals for single-seater cars and not any other type of car, GT cars, rally cars, nothing, only single-seaters. But anyway, it was very good for me that I found this site, because I, as you can see, the car looks good. It's been quite a hassle, to be honest, but I'm enjoying the look of it so far, and especially when it's finished, because I have some other projects that I want to start. So maybe 2 or 3 more days and it's finished. So that's it. Pretty short video. I know I'm not very good at describing what I've done, but I'm not good with anything related with cameras and similar. So I'll try to get better in the next videos. But so far, this is how the Williams looks, and hopefully the next video will be with a finished model. Since I'm not showing any live assembly or whatever, I decided not to, because it makes me lose focus on the kit, and sometimes I'm assembling and I'm out of alignment and so on, so it's pretty much a pain in the neck to do both things at the same time for now. But anyway, something that you see or you saw that has caught your attention, don't hesitate to ask. I'll be more than happy to answer and to help out if there's something you had problems before, or something similar, or maybe something completely different, it doesn't matter. So this is it, my part 5 of the Williams FW11. Hope to see you guys next time. Until then, take care.